Okay, there it is. So we have a foam roller, and I have some gliders, two gliders, and then I have a set of light weights. We're definitely gonna use the foam roller. You may use the glider, and then the light weights are also optional, okay? So, and as always, please just have whatever you need close by. Because you never know. You never know. Okay, I did all the things I need to do. Okay, so we're gonna start down on the mat with the foam roller. And everything else is kind of close by. Yeah, so I'll give you your first set of options. I'm gonna use the foam roller for this first part. I think we've done this before. The gliders can be used in place of this, just in case you don't have a foam roller, okay? So just like I'm doing now, you can sit either hands and knees, or if you can sit back, if your knees allow that, go ahead and kind of sit anywhere that just feels like a nice place to be. And then your hands will be wider than your shoulders with your palms facing each other. And I'm just going to start by letting my fingertips come forward and my forehead come towards the ground. And then I'm going to gently push down through the hands and come on back up again. So I don't have a ton of weight into my hands here. This is a really nice way to work the mobility of the shoulders, to get a nice little neck stretch here. Change your parts. If you would like, you can widen your knees. If for some reason it feels better to be palms down, go ahead and do palms down. You can also be a little bit more, like I said, on the knees instead of sitting back. That's a deeper stretch, I think, into the shoulders. Okay, so just give yourself a few of these to begin and kind of noodle around with where the rest of the body is, based on how your body is feeling. I just curled my toes forward, and even just keeping my feet like that, it also adds a little bit of a foot stretch in, which is kind of nice. So, yeah, like I said, this is great for shoulder mobility right here. And you're coming into a little bit of extension of the spine here, which is nice. I'm just gonna do two more with a nice deep breath. And PS, how can you use your gliders here? Like this. So it's pretty much the same thing. You get a deeper stretch with the foam roller. Okay, just to give you that visual. You don't have to. That's just your option. Okay? So we'll do one more here and we'll just pause for a minute and take one more nice deep breath here to really let the head be heavy. And then I'm going to come on up, and just for a moment, I'm going to come up onto the knees, bring my hands to my hips, bring my feet together. If your knees don't like having your feet together, just keep your feet separated, hands to hips. Press the hips into the hands. So you'll feel your tush fire, and you'll just feel like the whole front of this body part is just nice and long here. And then I'm gonna bring the arms out to the sides. Let's bring one arm down and the opposite arm up, and then stretch up and down at the same time. And then come on up, and we'll switch to the other side. So I have my right arm down, left arm up, big side stretch. Let's do two more of these. And one more each way. Let the ribs open. Draw the abdominals in. You can look down towards the floor. And other side. And come back to center. Okay? So here is another shoulder stretch slash mobility exercise. I'm going to start the same way we just did, sitting back towards my heels just a little bit. And at some point, I'm also just going to be sort of lifting away from the heels. Like I said, that's kind of up to you how far you go. I'm going to bring my left hand to the foam roller, and I'm going to take my right hand, sitting back towards my heels. I'm going to let my right arm start to go over towards the left. We can easily do this without the foam roller. We have done this before just on the mat. You can let your hand be on the glider for this as well if you don't have a foam roller, or if for some reason that feels better. And then you gently push down with the left arm and return to where you started. Okay, so it becomes a twist for the thoracic spine. I'm going to try that again. Sitting back a little bit towards the heels as I stretch my right arm over towards the left. So I end up sitting back as far as it kind of just intuitive feels like I should go. And then this is a twist through the middle spine. It feels really nice, actually. Take a nice deep breath. My head is full on resting on the ground here. I'm not like doing any work to be here. I'm just kind of enjoying the stretch. And then I'm going to gently draw the abdominals in and return. We'll just do this one more time. And yeah, if you only have a foam, a glider, you would do the same thing with a glider. This feels really nice too. A little bit less of a stretch. So take your third one. Right arm stretching over towards the left. This is a great thoracic twist here. This feels really nice. And then let's return. And we'll go to the other side. So now I'm going to keep my right hand there. And then I'll slide the left arm out to the side and the head is down. This is yet another exercise that just kind of reminds me why it's such a nice thing to travel if you're going on a car ride, to travel with your foam roller. Driving just really locks everything up. This is such a nice little stretch here for the thoracic spine. And come on back up. And we'll do one more. Left arm coming over to the right. Long neck here, sitting back towards your heels as far as you want to go. And one more deep breath. And return to center. And I'm going to come back up again where we just were. So my foam roller is OPTP. I often get ideas, like I got this whole little series idea from their Instagram account. They post such great mobility and strength things. I loved that. So let's come back one more time. Hands to hips, feet together, knees apart. Press the hips forward. Lift the chest. So we did a side to side. Let's do it one more twist this time from the knees. So arms just come wide. Twist left and you can look at your back hand. You can bring your hips with you a little bit if you want. And then return to center. Inhale. Twist right. One more each way. Twist left. And one more. Inhale. Twist right. And return to center, and then lower the arms down, okay? So from there, I'm gonna take my foam roller and put it long ways, and I'm gonna grab, for this, I'm just gonna push these guys off to the side. We don't need the gliders. I'm grabbing my lightweights. These are twos. I really honestly wouldn't go any heavier than twos or threes here, especially if you're tight across your chest. It'll be a super deep stretch. And then we're gonna sit on the edge of the foam roller, as far to the edge as you can, like the edge of my sacrum is right on the edge. And then have a lie down, okay? So get yourself situated, arms by your sides, feet hip distant, a little more, a little less is fine. And we'll start with, again, a little bit of shoulder mobility here. The arms can come a little bit closer in towards your sides, and you'll straighten the arms, lifting the elbows up. Quick little neck check in here. Actually, let's bring the hands a little bit wide for this. Hands are a bit wider than they just were. Bring your head to one side. So with care, let your head gently hang off to one side and then come right back toward the center and go over to the other side. So this is, for me, a very deep neck stretch. And again, just be careful how far you go. The head is heavy. One more each way. Of course, you're breathing. And last one here. Okay, so when we return to center, shoulders come away from the ears and the arms can come back in a little bit closer. We'll bring the arms up towards the ceiling. Draw your ribs in towards one another and down towards the foam roller. And then bring the arms back behind you. Go as far as you can go without letting those ribs shoot out toward the ceiling. Keep them sort of pulled in. And then come back and come all the way down towards the floor. And so that's the first little movement here. Ribs in, spine connected or somewhat connected or close to the foam roller, and you reach your arms back. Imagine the arms are moving through thicker air, thicker something. Just to give yourself a little extra resistance here and to work on that mobility a bit more, take that neck length with you. So try and keep the neck long. Let's just do two more here. Reaching back, adjust your parts if you need to. And one more time. Reach back. And we'll return and we're gonna come up and go into a circle. So I'm gonna flip my palms to face the ceiling as I circle all the way around. And then I'll come back by my sides to return to the floor. When I get to the floor, I'm gonna flip my palms, come all the way around. Ribs are still pulling in, reach back and return one more in this direction. Flip the palms, glide the fingertips out, big half circles. And then we'll come to the floor, but we're gonna reverse our circles. So we'll come up, palms face the ceiling, half circle your way all the way back. You can flip your palms so they face one another. And we'll do two more here. Breathe. One more time. And we'll just leave the arms there. Elbows bent, walk your feet in a little bit closer, adjust your arms if you need to. And I'm gonna bring the right leg up to tabletop and then bring it back down and the left leg. Okay, so as you alternate a leg, check in with the rest of you, keeping your midsection as still and stable as you can. If you need a little bit more stability today, bring your arms wider. Bring your arms just wider. And this is definitely going to stimulate the hip flexors. It's totally a hip flexor exercise, among other things. But keep your breath moving. You don't have to over tuck here. You don't have to be overly tucked. I did say connect to the foam roller, but have it be kind of in a neutral, natural way. Let's just do one more each way. Bring your left leg up and pause. The left knee is looking at the ceiling. Make a little circle around whatever it's looking at for 5, 4, 3, 2. And of course, we have to go the other way. Other way, so the knee is just making a little circle on the ceiling. 4 more here. Everything else is trying to remain still. 2 more, don't hold your breath. 1 more. Come back to the center, all the way down. Yes, I totally feel that in my flexor area. Opposite leg, the knee is looking at the ceiling and around. Notice if one side feels different from the other. 4 more here, 4, 3, 2. And we'll go the other way, around. Ball and socket joint, abdominals are pulled in. Last 3, 2, and 1 more. And then we'll come all the way back down. I'm gonna keep my arms kind of wide. Bring your feet together and your knees together. Draw the abdominals in. Keeping your knees together, extend one leg and then bend, return and put the foot back down. Opposite leg, extend and bend. You can extend your arms a little bit more and change around the dynamics there. The more narrow you go, the more challenging this little exercise gets. The wider you go with your arms, the more support you get from them. All right, so you can play around with that. Luckily, you're pretty close to the floor, just in case you roll off your foam roller. Knees are squeezing just a little bit. Let's do two more sets here, too. Let's flex the foot as you come up. Flex, calf stretch. And flex, long through the neck. One more each way. Yes, and then I'm just going to put the feet back down and then walk the feet out again so they're a bit wider than my hips. Now the arms don't have to do as much work. So the feet are a bit wide. I'm going to carefully reach out, grab onto my light weights. We'll come back to shoulder arm stuff. So I'm holding onto my weights right by my sides. Belly button is pulled in a little bit. Arms are going to come up right over the shoulders. And I'm going to turn so my palms are facing forward. And I'm going to bend my elbows towards the ground. Maybe the elbows will tap the ground. And then you'll just return right back up. So this is a light weight. This is more for stretch than it is for strength. As you bring your elbows towards the floor, they have that deeper range of motion they can go. So enjoy that little bit of a stretch. We're just going to do four more like this. Four. And three. And two. One more time here. Okay, and this is where it gets exciting. Bring your elbows out and pause. Slowly bring the weights down towards the floor in your cactus shape. Ooh! And breathe. Mm-hmm. Yep. If the weights are too intense, please just release them and hold in this position without the weights. I certainly don't want you to strain or pull any muscles across the chest. Give yourself two more deep breaths here. Honestly, I think most people I know should be doing this stretch every single day and just like hold the stretch for 1 to 2 minutes. I think it's a really valuable release across the chest. Release your weights, please. Just leave them where they are. And then come out of that situation. So just bring the arms back down by your sides, okay? We're gonna use those weights later. So the arms will come a little bit wide again. This time I'm gonna do arms straight, fingertips down. Legs will come back in towards one another, pretty close. We're gonna bring the right leg into tabletop. And then I'm also gonna bring the left leg into tabletop. So I've got both legs up. I'm gonna bring the feet and the knees together. Just quick little belly check-in. Really draw the abdominals in and pull the knees over your belly button, okay? Legs are gonna open away from one another and then return. We'll add a deep breath to this. Inhale as you open, exhale as you return. Five more. Four. Three. One more. One leg returns to the floor, other one as well. Relax the arms by your sides. Take a nice deep breath. Inhale, exhale. Okay, arms will come a little bit wider again. Straighten the arms, lift the elbows, fingertips down. One leg, let's do the opposite leg first into tabletop, if you know which one you started with last time, and then you bring your second leg up. So I'm gonna find a little bit of a diamond shape here. Knees a little bit wide, feet up, small movement. Lower lift, lower lift. Again, aim to get your knees over your belly button or your ribs. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Last one. All the way back down. Rest your arms down. Take an inhale, exhale. Okay. This time, again, arms remain the same, a little bit wide, fingertips down, arms nice and straight. Feet are going to come in towards one another pretty close. I'm going to keep the left leg bent, and I'm going to straighten the right leg out and then glide it right back in. So I'm just kind of sliding it on the floor. And now the left leg, slide it up. Return. Just one more each way like this. Left leg remains bent, slide the right leg out. Slide it back in, other side. Okay, so we're gonna come back to the right. I'm gonna glide the right leg out, draw the abdominals in, and come up towards the ceiling and back down. Just tap the floor, glide it back in, left leg. Glide it out, left leg. Up, lower down, glide it in, right leg, out. Up, down. Glide it in, left leg, out, up, down, glide it in, one more with the right, out, down, glide it in, and with the left, down, and glide it in. Just relax the arms, wiggle your fingers, take an inhale, exhale. Okay, so I'm going to start with my arms a bit closer and my elbows down. And I'm going to come back again to the one leg coming up to tabletop at a time. Aim to bring the knee directly over the ribs. And as long as this is still good for you, we're going to add an opposite arm, reach up, and then back down. And again, so right arm, left leg. You may keep your elbow down, or you may go back to that slightly less supportive arm position, just the fingertips down. And abdominals are really pulled in here. Neck is nice and long. We'll do three more sets. Breathe. Three. And three. Two. Try to really like flow through this. Don't get clunky when you put your hands and your feet down, nice and quiet. And one more, each way. Let's come up with the right knee and the left arm. Right knee, left arm. Keep the right knee where it is. PS, right knee over the ribs or the belly button. Left arm, straight out to the left side, all the way down. Maybe tap the palm down and return. Right leg. A little bit out to the right and back to the center. So the arm will go left and the knee will go right. Maybe not all the way. Not so easy. Left arm goes out left, right knee goes out to the right. Maybe not too far. Just one more here. Breathe. And I'm going to put those parts down. I'm going to try the other side. Left leg up. Right arm up. The right arm first. I'm going to practice, see how that feels. Out to the right and return. Left knee out to the left a little bit. Ooh, that's a lot harder. Right arm, left leg out to the sides and return. Breathe. Out to the sides. Yeah, I'm definitely using my left hand into the mat here, that's for sure. Out to the sides and return. One more time. And return, come all the way down. Okay, quick flexor and hip stretcher. You can bring your feet together and your knees wide. And breathe. Two more exhales here. Okay, come on back up. Okay, I think we're going to roll off of this foam roller now. So I'm just going to roll to the right, let the foam roller come out from underneath me. Enjoy that brief moment, brief strange feeling of the spine feeling the way that it does right now. Just take a breath or two here, inhale, exhale. Okay, let's just keep the foam roller off to the side for a moment and bring the arms by our sides. Feet come in a bit close. Feet about as wide as the hips. Push down with the arms, push down with the full foot. Bring the hips up a little bit and then lower back down. Small lifts here for 8 and then lower down. As you're lifting and lowering here, try to find your big toe and your little toe, the inside and the outside of the heel into the ground. Full 4-point connection to the ground with your feet. 4 more here. 4. And 3. And 2. 1 more. And then lower all the way down. Okay, so I'm gonna take my foam roller. Let's see if I can do this without sitting up. I'm just gonna slide this right underneath myself, under my knees, so it's long ways, so then I can just kind of grab it with my feet and add the foam roller to this fun that we were just doing. For me, using the foam roller for bridging, I have to really be on the right place with my foot, otherwise my hamstrings really go nuts. For me, pushing my heels down, like pulling in and down towards the ground really helps. Okay, so play around with where your feet are. Press through your arms, take a super deep breath, and then lift your hips. Inhale, come down. Exhale, come up. Adjust your feet if you need to. It really is kind of funny for me. If my legs or feet are in the wrong place, I really don't like this. But when they're in the right place, I actually don't mind it. It kind of feels like a nice addition to this move. I'm going to continue to keep my shoulder blades pulled down, my neck nice and long. 4 more here. 4. And 3 more. And 2. One more time. And we're gonna lower just for a moment. Extend the legs by rolling out onto the foam roller. When I do it, when I get out there, I'm gonna flex my feet and pause nice and long through the legs. Point the feet and flex. Hold here. Bring the big toes together, tap them, and then bring the toes completely apart. So external rotation, internal rotation. Try to really have this be not only from the hips, of course your legs are going to move in the hips, but really move the feet and the ankles here as you go in towards one another with your big toes out away from one another. Come back to center, really point, reach the toes away, really flex, come back, and we're going to glide the foam roller right back in where we started, come back to where you started, arms by your sides, okay? So now I'm gonna keep my feet hip distant, maybe slightly more or less, and I'm coming back up with my hips, not too high. Find those long arms, find the long neck. The knees will stay still, just the hips are gonna hopefully move. Lower the right hip, come on back up, and then the left hip. So I can see my knees, not perfectly, because that would mean I would have to lift my head. But I'm keeping an eye on them. They're staying central. And so I'm lowering the hip, tushy tap, return. And then the opposite hip, tushy tap, return. 4 more. 4. 4. And 3. 3. 2. 2. 1, and 1 more. Return, lower the hips at the same time. And again, we will glide all the way out on top of that foam roller again. Flex the feet, fully extend the legs. Point, and flex. One more, go in, tap the big toes, go out. One more each way. Point, flex, In and out. And then just relax for a minute. Relax the feet. Take a nice deep breath. And exhale. Okay? You can come off of the foam roller and just kind of leave it where it is. And then we're going to roll to the side. Come on up to sit. And I'm just going to turn myself around now. I'll keep the foam roller there, but I'm going to put my back against it. Let's say mid back, hands behind the head, okay? So adjust yourself wherever you are on the foam roller so it feels like a nice place to be, nice-ish. And we're just gonna come into extension like we did at the beginning of class, but we were on our hands and knees. So the head goes below the line of the foam roller, which, PS, is of course optional. If for some reason it doesn't feel good for you or it's contraindicated based on anything that's happening with your spine, your neck, your shoulders, go as far as you feel like you should. And I'm just gonna do about four more here. Sometimes just gently adjusting where you are, where your spine is on the foam roller by scooching forward or back. It just feels like a nice little massage, which I think feels so nice. Let's do one more here. And curl up. Okay, from here, I'm gonna keep my right hand behind my head and I'm gonna extend my left arm towards my left knee. I'm gonna draw my abdominals in. PS, knees and feet, I think together is nice. Let's bring the right leg into an extended position. And I'm gonna take my left fingertips and go on the outside of my right knee for a little pulse. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'll come back to where I started, right foot down. Switch the hands, left hand back, right arm extended. Curl yourself forward so you're nice and engaged through the abdominals. Extend the left leg, bring your right hand on the outside of the left knee, and a little side pulse here. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to center, replace the foot, both hands behind the head, curl forward, reach your elbows forward just a little bit so you can really see them in your periphery vision. Bring the right leg into tabletop, just a little pulse forward. I'm just gonna keep that right leg there. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we'll switch. Other leg, up, and 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Foot down, all the way back with the head, and if you'd like, you can stretch the arms back. Ooh, that's a big stretch. Take a big old inhale, exhale here. You can come into a cactus if you want to torture yourself in this position one more time. Inhale, exhale. I like to bring my hands behind my neck. Exhale, behind my head, I should say. Exhale to return to curling forward. Okay, and I'm gonna scooch back, hands behind the thighs, come all the way up to sit. Yeah. Okay, so let's come onto our bellies. Similar set of feelings, I think, to what we did in the beginning, but more for the spine than the shoulders. And just to throw that out there, this is another place that if your shoulders are really tight, being up here on the foam roller is probably a little bit too intense. You're welcome to grab your gliders. This is another place where you can bring your hands right on the gliders and just do the same stuff, really, that we're gonna do with the foam roller, okay? So I'm gonna extend my arms out so my palms are, or my wrists slash palms are kind of on top of the foam roller, and then the forehead will come down. So just find a nice long spine feeling. Draw the ribs and the belly button in a little bit.
And then start to push down through your palms to lift the head and the chest and come forward. When you lift, look straight ahead. And then you can bring your chin in and lower yourself back down. We're just gently rolling back and forth on the foam roller a bit. And we'll try that again. Lifting, and gosh, you may come up higher than me or not as much, or again, you may be using the gliders. All of those are okay. Let's do four more. And lower down. Three more. Breathe. I like inhale on the way up. I think it feels nice. Two more. One more time. And all the way down. Okay, so you can just kind of relax your head down. I'm gonna turn so my karate chop side of the hand is on the glider, sorry, foam roller. And this time I'm gonna try to come up a little bit higher and then roll back out. We're gonna do three more here. My arms are a little bit wider than they just were. Pressing down into the foam roller a bit more. Lowering down, two more. Lift and lower. One more here. Lift and come all the way down. Okay, I'm gonna bring my hands underneath my shoulders and then sit back for a nice deep breath. Inhale, exhale. One more deep breath here. And then we can roll it up. That's a lot for the shoulders, you know. You can always please just dial that back based on what works for you or doesn't. I'm gonna grab my light weights here. We're gonna come down onto, I'm coming down on my left side. For now, the foam roller can just come off to the side. We don't need you. So I'm coming onto my side, grabbing my two little weights. I'm gonna use both of them. I have twos here for some rotator work. Head on your arm. P.S. You could also put your head on your foam roller if you would prefer that, okay? Quick spine check-in. Imagine your head, your back, your tush is pulling up into a wall or something that's nice and straight. Draw the abdominals in. And as you lower and lift your arm here, try to keep the elbow kind of connected to your side. And also, try not to sink your bottom ribs towards the floor. You should feel kind of lifted away from the floor here. And we'll do six and five and four, three, two, one more. And then come all the way down. I'm just gonna leave the weights there for a moment and bring my hand right in front of the ribs. And I'm gonna extend both legs out on a bit of a forward angle, and the top leg will come up. Another just quick check in here, just continue to not sink your ribs towards the floor. Top leg will come forward and back. I like flex forward, point back of the top foot. You can challenge yourself here by being a little bit less connected to the ground. And just a quick note here, I usually have a mat underneath me, but it's, I don't even know where it is. If your bottom hip ever is sore into the ground, you can bend your bottom knee. And that usually takes the pressure off of that, okay? Let's do three more here. Three. And two, one more. And then we'll come back, legs long at an angle, top leg up and down. And seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Hover over your bottom leg. Make that top leg longer than you thought you could. That usually helps me to lift the ribs away from the mat. Small circles here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three,
2, and we'll go the other way. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your top knee to the floor in front of you. You can also put your top knee on your foam roller just to give it a little bit of a lift here. I'm going to keep mine on the ground. Bottom leg is going to lift and lower. Lift and lower. For 6, 5, 4, maybe point the foot. 3, 2. Now lift and hold. Let's flex that left foot. Little pulse up here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Maybe a little higher. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, maybe a little higher, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's put that leg down, bring the top leg back out to the party. Scooch both legs back so we're a bit more in a straight line. Make sure you're really on your side here. Wobble around until you find a place where you can balance. And then lift both legs and lower down. I kind of like to bring my top arm towards the ceiling. Sometimes I like to lift my head here. Try not to overly push yourself up. Let's do 3 more. 2 more. 1 more. And we'll come back where we started. Knees bent. Grab the weights, and we'll do 8 more for the rotator here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 more here, and then come all the way down. Let's just leave those weights there. Just for fun, this is another thing I saw. I was like, I thought to myself yesterday, I wanted to throw this in. So clam, right? People call this whole knee lift, clamshell, whatever. Bring your top knee up. Bring your heels together. Lift the heels away from the ground. So I don't have my bottom foot just resting here. I have my heel kind of lifted. And that's where the exercise lives, with the heels lifted. So just the knee comes down, so the leg kind of closes in on the bottom leg and comes back up. There is something about that that sort of makes you feel that side a little bit more somehow. I don't know how. Let's do 8 more here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 more time, and lower the legs. Okay, we're just going to come up and over to the other side, but before we come over to the other side, I'm going to leave my legs in the direction they were just looking, and I'm just going to slide the legs open a little bit so the left foot is against the right thigh, and then my right hand is going to come to my ankle here. Left arm's gonna come up, and this is just a big, lovely stretch through the whole left side. Ooh, so nice. And then we can come back to the ground, stretch over the other way. We'll just do one more over to the right. You can look down towards your hand to deepen the twist. And then come back. We'll come to the other side. Okay, so come onto your right side or opposite side. Use your foam roller or anything else you want to support your neck and back if you need to. Quick little spine check-in. Make sure you're nice and straight as if you were against the wall. And I'm going to start by holding on both of the weights. And 8, 7, 6, lifting your rib, your bottom ribs away from the ground a little bit here. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1 more. And then come all the way down. I'm going to leave my weights there. Bring my hand in front of the ribs. Extend the legs out. Top leg lifts just a little bit. P.S.
push your bottom leg down into the ground, just a little bit, just for a little add structure, and back and forth through the top leg. And back. Trying to keep your upper body nice and long. And five, four, three, two, one more time, breathe. And then come back, one leg, top leg right on the bottom, a little bit of turnout, up and down. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one more. Hover over the bottom leg. Make that leg longer than you thought you could. It may help you to lift away from the floor. Little circles. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and we'll go the other way. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. I'm going to bend my top knee and bring the leg forward. Bottom leg is going to lift, and I'm pointing that foot to begin. Little pulse up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now lift and hold. We'll flex the foot. Little quick pulse. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Maybe a little higher. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Maybe a little higher. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Ooh, all the way down. Both legs come out. Get yourself balancing on your side the best you can. And both legs will lift. I like to try and find my balance. Lower down the sides, always a little weirder. You can add the head lift if you'd like. And shoulder, try not to push yourself up. I flip my bottom palm so it looks up, so I don't use that bottom arm too much. Two more here. One more time. And come all the way down. So let's find that weird little situation here. So bring your top knee up. Lift your heel away from the ground so your bottom heel is lifted away from the ground. So then when you lower left, you're just kind of staying on top of that bottom heel. Keeping your top hip pretty still. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one more. And come all the way down. Last little rotator set here. Grab those weights. Long neck. Belly's in. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. Last one. And come all the way down. Okay, I'm going to put those weights away. Quick little stretch here. Let's bring the bottom arm forward and the top arm over. Deep breath. You can goalpost your arms here or cactus your arms here if you want to get that chest stretch in. One more time. One more really good exhale here. Release any tension you're feeling. And then we can carefully bring the legs over to the other side.
Two more deep breaths here.
Okay, so I'm just gonna roll to the side. Come on back up one more time. You can choose to use your foam roller for this next bit or not. I'm always on the fence about how I feel about this, but we're gonna be bringing the foam roller underneath the palms to do some knee lifts here. If it's too much pressure into your wrist, just come to the ground instead. Hands are shoulder distance apart. The more I let my wrists sink in toward my knees, the more I don't like this. Just gently roll your foam roller away. If you can see, that was pretty subtle what I just did. It's easy to do that, which is kind of yucky. I'm really kind of using my fingers here. I'm rolling the foam roller away a little bit just to have some more strength through the wrist. Okay, and maybe softening the elbows. I don't know, play around with that. Toes are forward, belly button is in. I'm gonna lift my knees. Inhale here. And then lower back down. Very wristy. Very wristy. I think I'm gonna try one on the ground without the foam roller. Yeah, that's way nicer. One more time here. And then come all the way down. Uncurl your toes for a minute. Just come all the way up. Give those wrists just a little bit of a break here for a minute. Inhale, exhale. Come back to the mat one more time. Hands underneath the shoulders. I'm going to come into a modified plank position here. So I'm going to keep my knees down, abdominals in, wide elbow push-ups. Six of them. Six. Five. Four, three, two, one more. I didn't plan on tapping my head to the foam roller, but that was kind of exciting. Come up for a minute, give your wrists a break. Reach the arms wide, lift the chest, inhale, exhale. Okay. Come back one more time. I'm gonna keep the knees underneath my hips. And my hands are gonna come in a little bit more now. I'm gonna bend my elbows towards my knees and then push the mat away. I wanna really try to use all 10 fingers here. Four more here. Four. Tricep push-up. Modified, of course. Three. Two. One more. Ooh, okay. That's enough of those. Let's come all the way up to stand. Come on up to stand. Okay. So just our last little bit here with the foam roller. I'm going to kick mine against the wall. So it's just right up against the wall there. And then I'm going to bring my hands against the wall. I'm going to bring my right foot forward. The further forward I step my left foot, the deeper this calf stretch becomes. You can just try and really stand tall here. The more hunched over I get, also I don't feel the stretch as much either. So stand nice and tall. Kind of try to square your hips off a little bit. You can also move your foot a little. I'm leaning my foot in towards my big toe and then out towards the pinky, in towards the big toe. I'm just kind of slightly moving the foot and the ankle a little bit to deepen the calf stretch. And then come central. Stand tall. Take one more deep breath. And then we'll switch. Other side. Okay, so adjust yourself. So you can, again, stand tall here. Move that foot around. Shift in and out. In and out. One more each way. And then come back to the center. Stand nice and tall. Inhale, exhale. Yeah. And then we're going to step back a little bit. And we'll just find parallel feet or heels together, toes apart, whichever one you like better. I may come here actually. And we'll inhale, bring the arms all the way up. And then exhale, come down. Ear to shoulder, right ear to right shoulder, and then left ear to left shoulder. Half circle in one direction, breathe. Half circle in the other direction. And then come back up to the center. We'll find parallel feet. We'll do one roll down to end. So soften your knees, relax your shoulders, take a breath. And roll through the spine. Heavy upper body. And then we'll slowly come back up. Keep your breath moving. Roll it up. At the top, relax your shoulders. Give yourself one belly breath. All right, we did it. Have a lovely day. May the force be with you.